Oh, I didn't see you there. Hi, I'm Brian Torbick. I could be chasing, but my time would be wasted. They got nothing on you. Nothing on you, babe. Nothing on you. It was a couple of weekends ago, actually. I was visiting Zero Gravity with a couple of friends. And you know, I'm just on the dance floor, I'm just doing my thing, and you know what, I'm hot. Literally. The manager walked over and said, you should probably get a drink of water, your face is turning really red. And I obliged, because I wanted to be hospitable. Nice, I wanted to be nice. And so I go over to the bar, I get myself a kitty cocktail, and I see this girl, and she's looking at me. And so I go, hey, my name's Brian. And you know what? She turns to me, and as I think she's grabbing a pen to write down my number, she grabs a syringe out of her pocket and stabs me in the neck and screams, welcome to the world of AIDS! And then she runs away. Oh. No. Oh my God. I thought the question was, what was your worst dream? Oh. No, no. That didn't happen. That was a night. That didn't happen in real life. Coming at your mouth with your blah, blah, blah. Yes. Oh, you want me to share one of them? Okay, you didn't say that in your question, so naturally I was confused. Okay, no, no, it's not your fault. Except it is. Talents. One, I know how to stay very calm in stressful situations. Oh, okay, we're here. One sec.
Just too real, there's just too much that time cannot erase.
Oh my God!
Ayo B, what up, A? What we want? Want them to say?
The only fear I have is probably becoming so good looking that I become attracted to myself. Oh wait, that already happened. Can you look at this? Allergies are all psychosomatic. The only reason I'm allergic to raccoons is because one bit me while I was peeing in the forest once. Baby, there's a shark in the water. My pet peeves. Oh, I have one. When people on Facebook become fans of really stupid things. The other day I was on Facebook and this girl who shall remain anonymous, Becky McNicholas, she became a fan of that feeling in your stomach you get when the guy you like texts you first, and so you text him back, and then he doesn't respond for 2 hours, and so you check your phone to see why he hasn't responded, and you realize that you never sent the text, and so then you send the text, and you say, sorry, I didn't send the text, I'm so sorry, please don't hate me, and he goes, oh, it's okay, because I was at football practice, and so then you start dating. That's not a real thing, that never happens, how could you become a fan of that? Back up, baby, back up. Yes, I have overcome many obstacles, actually. As a child, I was born not with two legs, but a fin. And it was necessary for my health that I stay in water all day long. So my parents forced me to live in the bathtub. And constantly, my older sister would come in. And she'd have a soccer ball, and she'd go, oh, hey, Brian. Hey, Brian. Hey, do you want to go play soccer outside with me? Because you can, because you got a fin. And I would cry. But nobody would notice because I was in a bathtub, so I was already wet. So my parents basically forgot about me. And so I would sit in there and sing about how I wanted to be part of my sister's world. Up on the streets where they walk and talk and play all day in the sun? That sounds like fun to me. The Little Mermaid? I'm not aware with such a film. What inspires me? Well, I'll tell you. Lolcats. A lolcat picture is when you take a picture of a cat when it's in a funny position, and then you put a caption underneath it, and when you read the caption along with the picture of the cat, you loll. which is short for laughing out loud. You laugh out loud. There's this one picture of this one lolcat that my friend sent to me, and I was lolling so hard that I literally urinated in my pants. That's how much I was lolling. I go your vertigo stick,
while you and Mara window, Lady Gaga.
Roma, Gaga, ooh la la, wild yellow romance.